Well, hello. I was actually going to do this yesterday, but I wound up not having time for it. So, here we are. Alright, let's kill the music. Switch over the screen. So, before I forget...
Open for business. Strangers in the night, exchanging glances.
Thanks, TMMA, for the follow. I keep wanting to pronounce that Tima, because there was a soccer player I used to follow whose name was Tim Tima. It wasn't spelled like that, but the pronunciation makes sense. So, I have zero clue what this is. Nope, that's not going to help me either. So let's just jump right in and see what happens. This action RPG features hardcore action set in ancient Egypt. According to its developers, Pharaonic takes the combat design of Dark Souls and... You know, I saw the Unity logo right after reading that, and now I have two red flags. And adapt it to a fast-paced side-scroller. The request is to reveal the secret of Amosis... Oh, Amosis the First, the Red Pharaoh. Sorry, I just saw the letter I, and I wasn't sure how to approach that at first. But to do so, you'll have to explore a huge kingdom full of dangerous enemies, deadly traps, and fearsome creatures. If you hope to have any chance at all against the Red Pharaoh's army, you'll have to improve your combat skills and equip... And it cuts off there. Also, this is another one that's in the new type of sleeve. Which makes me... Oh yeah, there's another label under this. Hold on, let me see what it is. This was a sleeve for MLB The Show 21, and they just pasted another label over it. If you look... Like, you won't be able to see it on the webcam, but... Well, maybe you can. You can kind of see the faded text, like, right here. Where it just says, Show 21. Barely, but it's there. Recycle, everybody. Hi, Blondie. Hi, Haru. So, this could either be a pleasant surprise, or it could fall apart very quickly. And I'm never sure which it's going to be. Alright, they allow for reassigning a bunch of different buttons. That's encouraging, actually. Let's see, dodge, attack, shield, parry, interact. I assume that there will be more info on this in the game. So let's just not waste time. Oh no. Oh, why would you do this? I'm gonna be here for half an hour. Nah, we gotta fix this. Ugh. Something about the way they do the faces is mildly terrifying. Not sure why you have one that's tanned when all of them are kind of tanned. I guess it's just whatever style of diaper I want the most. That seems fine. Is swollen really the best way to describe that haircut? Is this a flat top? Oh, it's a flat top. We gotta go with this. Again, they call this one pointy, but they all kind of come to a point. Sailor. So... You know what? Just for the name alone, I'll go for that. You know, we're picking our character traits, but in the process, we're also creating the personality and backstory for our character. Because right now, we are a southern fancy sailor man. Sure. There's no voice for this, is there? Wait a minute. So in 440 years, he reincarnated 30 times. Which means that... Like, did the life expectancy drop for each subsequent reincarnation? You know, this is actually kind of how the tutorial section for EverQuest starts out. But I had way fewer questions for that. I would guess it was an ancient Egyptian slave simulator. It may still be. Oh, if there's no dialogue, that means everyone's going to talk with their hands, huh? Sure. Wait, are we gonna light the torch at any point? This is a $15 game, so they probably didn't have budget for VOs. You know, you say that, but you would be surprised, like, how cheap you can get some VAs. You just gotta know where to look. Oh, I thought we were gonna light that on fire. No. How much you want to bet this is gonna end poorly? I couldn't tell from the camera where the blade was gonna come from. So now I know. That's better. Again, this is not how I expected to end up using the torch as a blunt object, and not lighting anything on fire. Moving on. Alright, we got a shield and a blunt object that you're supposed to set on fire. So it looks like the Dark Souls elements are the stamina bar and maybe some basic concept principles. Why is it telling me to parry when I can't parry? Oh, and there's a you died screen, so I guess that's Dark Souls 2. All right, well, that turned out better because we got an equipment drop. Okay. Going a little far with the Dark Souls stuff. Let's run back and save, because I don't know how often that thing will, like, either of those enemies will drop equipment, but since I got something, I want to make sure I hang on to it. Oh, he just dropped the same thing. Wait, did both of them respawn? Both of them respawned. How do I... Oh. It's just a button press. Okay. Enemies recovering after saving is another Dark Souls staple. Good to know, I suppose. Well, sir, I can only walk on a set two-dimensional path. Is that going to be a problem? No, damn it, that's not what I wanted to do. See if I can go to a menu and get a map, but I'm not seeing anything. Oh shit. Did he equip that? Okay, he did. Couldn't tell because he was already wearing basically the same thing as his no equipment. When was the last save point that I hit? I'm understanding the Dark Souls influence, but this is a little more clunky. Crown of the you're really going that route already? Come on, there's got to be... Okay. This isn't a particularly helpful map, but it's what I have to work with. Action seems very floaty. That's a good word for it, actually. Jeez, the hay was popping in. I have no idea what a Shabti gem is, but let's see if it's any good. It looked like he dropped something. I couldn't tell what it was, though. Yeah, I've already been told that, thanks. Oh, that's terrible. Thank you. Alright, I hit parry and nothing happened. Which means we just lost a ton of progress. Oh my god, we're all the way back here. Nope. No thanks. I guess this. And this. What is that noise? It's like my future self is coming through here and fighting stuff too. Already speedrun? I speedrun when a game pisses me off. Sometimes. Okay, would have been good to know that this was here before. Magician in me says, just pick up the shield that they dropped. But no. You can put away the prompt now, I get it. Well, that sound is the warden torturing people, even though it just sounds like regular fight noises. I found the key to that other guy's cell before, so I should probably take care of that. Unless I already did? Hold on, let me see. Oh, that quest is already done, I guess. Wait. Okay, I thought I saw stuff popping in at the edges of the screen. I probably did, but I can't replicate it. Let me guess. I have to dodge that. Supreme Victor. Hey, that's a Killer Instinct thing. So, after that boss fight, I mean, on a very basic level, I see use backpack power. On a very basic level, I see the Dark Souls inspiration, but that's pretty much all it is just base level inspiration. I can't use backpack power. Oh, I had to have the backpack first, of course. But why would it give me the prompt to do that before I even had it? Sad cake-eating Jago knows. Jago. Now we shall see if you are the dang it, Bobby, I think. I had a feeling that name was gonna come back to bite me. Wait, Thebes, where are we now? Well, after the warning about soldiers, I'm definitely going to save. Doesn't look bad, but it's just side-scrolling ancient Egyptian Dark Souls and not much else. I don't know even about that. Why was he talking like he was in a Shakespeare play, but everyone else is just kind of speaking normally? Oh, what now? The timing on that parry is unusually tight. There are some times it looks like I've landed them, and then it just didn't count. Some questions about the controls. Do I just go for blocks from now on? Because parries are really messing with my head.
Mm-hmm.
hate that they respawn immediately. Egypt. Yes, Nero, this is Egypt Souls. More or less. Can I go now? Finally, we can move on. Never mind. Well, fuck that, I guess. Oh, Tiger? Since you're there, let Jeremiah know that his yelling at video games has come through on the mic multiple times. God. Mm-hmm. So, quick poll. Are we going to be able to make any progress outside of this village? So yeah, the opening area, really easy. This area just says fuck it and throws waves of enemies at you. Hold on, I'm gonna go yell at the roommate. Alright, where were we? I wasn't planning on this being a really short stream, but it may just end up being that. That is such a load of shit that you still get hit by that. I'll just say fuck it and go get my memories or whatever. I'll get the souls thing. Okay, the dodging just didn't do anything. Do you have an alternate game? No, I only get one GameFly game at a time. Because what kind of madman wants more than one GameFly game at a time? Given my standards for GameFly games, who would want more than one at a time? Wouldn't be as frustrating as if it were consistent. Wait, hold on while I count the money. $98, $99. Alright, we'll just say that's 200. Well, at least I got a better piece of equipment, I guess? But I'm still kind of screwed. You know what, maybe I was wrong. Maybe the difficulty spike is the Dark Souls inspiration, and nothing else. Alright, I was gonna ask you to craft something, but apparently that's not what you want to do. Was the phrase shitstorm very common in Egyptian times? We had a guy speaking Middle English before, and this guy's just throwing modernisms like shitstorm around. He also said, tell you what. Which makes it more appropriate that my character's named Dang It Bobby. Oh, that bitch. So I kind of got lost in the dialogue a bit. What was the actual quest? He hadn't even swung the weapon yet, and I died. Are you ready to do a lot of that shit over again? 'Cause I'm not. Oh yeah, I can't attack very much with this at all. Okay, I could buy that. Now I can't afford the light armor, I'm assuming. No, I cannot. So it's like just inherently an excuse for them to be unfair. You said it, not me. Wonderful. Okay, this weapon does seem to be paying off a bit more. And that is a definite equipment upgrade. Fuck it, give me my armor. I'm meeting the skill requirements. I will not tolerate that. We're doing it again. Oh, this is the captain I was supposed to look for. Assassin's Creed Odyssey is looking good. I mean, by comparison, or... Seeing this much Egypt makes you want to play Crash 3. Damn, I hadn't even thought of that. So if we die at this point, we lose a shit ton of progress. Okay, good. Oh, so I'm guessing I just have the one key for that? All right. Side-scrolling spin-off of AC Morigin. Why did I call it AC Morigins? Assassin's Creed Origins. You know what, this is the mobile version. Assassin's Creed Odyssey, go. I mean, why not? Of a beer, a wench, and a laugh. Why are you talking like a Bard's Tale character? Well, at least I know where that fountain is. Son of a bitch. Okay, so you can't dodge over the switch. You just have to try and dodge at the right time that the trap pops up. That seems like a roundabout way of doing it, but fine, whatever you say. Oh, right. I already did that. All that to get to a dead end. Only people in this world could use another axis of movement. Look, that's a lot of development time, okay? We want a 2D, we're sticking to 2D, no matter how much the graphics flash in the background when I don't want them to. Why is it doing that? Oh, that was it? I'm used to there being multiple waves of bullshit. Ah, shit, we're back here. Wait, if we're back here, I'm going to run down and save real quick. Let's sell some of this excess equipment that I have. Looks like I have my best options as far as light armor goes. That's a lot of money, but... This is incredibly vague about what it does. Most likely worse given the popularity of this type of game. Yeah. Yeah, that's a fair assessment. Anyway, let's spend a whole lot on a ring that I don't know what it does. Well, that is popping on the sides. I knew I was seeing something. I have so many skirts. And in any other context, that would be a really creepy statement. Ah, the golden legs are technically a step down. Too bad. Alright, I got lost again. What am I supposed to be doing? Alright, finding the keys. Alright, I don't know where any of those locations are. And this incredibly vague map doesn't really help. I'm just trying to go places that I don't think I've been before. Okay, this looks different. We may actually be making progress in this game. Does Valley of Kings have a valley of save points? Grand Vizier, dang it, Bobby. I don't know why I find that somewhat amusing, but I do. Egypt was ahead of its time. Clearly. Them and Greece. Excuse you. Right. I don't need a map, I just need a save point. Whoa. Was that screen tearing or a flickering texture? I think that was a flickering texture. That's not what I wanted to do. So this took a bit of a turn. I just have a pile of- Okay, that was definitely screen tearing. Jeez, it's like watching an old VHS tape. battled Nemesis. So there was a massive difficulty spike earlier. Now I feel like the difficulty has really gone down. And yes, I am waiting for karma to bite me in the ass. Also, I still don't know how to use the magic. Or it was circle, wasn't it? All right, useful. Quite useful. Is the stream strike? Oh, jeez. Yeah. I just saw my bitrate drop. How bad is it? Is Dwayne dancing, or is he in freeze frame mode? I say it's the game. The game is still running fine for me. It's entirely going to be the stream. Oh, hello, grass. Nice of you to join us. Can you at least tell what's going on? You know, I thought we were doing it the entire time, but apparently we're going to fight like an Egyptian. name is almost certainly a Kickstarter. Oh. Oh, you're going to search for if this game is crowdfunded? I'm not going to assume anything. Also, why did my HUD just completely disappear? Okay, there it is. Well, I guess I should refuel while I'm here. Buffering got worse. Oh, great. But what do you think we should do? Should I try playing through it, or do we wait a bit for it to pass? There's no Kickstarter for this. All right, good. Crisis averted. I say that as someone who has backed dozens of games, but still. So what usually happens with the buffering is it's like this for a little bit and then it eventually goes away. So do we wait for it to go away, or do I just continue playing the game? Frankly, I could go either way at this point. I was hoping that if this did happen, it wouldn't happen until later. Back when you're richer? I'm not sure how that fits either of my recommendations. Like, do I just keep playing or do I wait for it to pass? Or do I go next door and tell Jerry to stop downloading porn? Actually, wait, is my voice even going through? I can't tell. Right now, my bitrate is at about half of what it usually is, sometimes dipping lower than that. I'm counting on you guys, because I cannot see what the stream looks like. Hard to tell if and when it'll get back. Yeah, that's the unfortunate thing, is I can't predict any of this. Can you see what's going on? Because I don't know if it's just a lower than usual frame rate, or if it's a slideshow, or if it keeps cutting out and buffering over and over. This is not the evening I envisioned. I would say cut the stream and come back, but that usually doesn't help. Why you gotta do this connection? Sounds like this. I wish fiber was available in this neighborhood. I'm not gonna lie, guys, I'm kind of counting on your input. Do I keep going? Do I stop? I love how the camera pans away from the enemy that I'm trying to face. Since no one's saying anything, I'm just going to keep pushing through this. And hopefully the bitrate improves at some point. Great when you don't know what an enemy's gonna do and then you just die. Oh, his hitbox wasn't active. Great. You only just now heard my reply to you? Oh geez, that's really bad. The weird thing is, my stream is still showing as dropping frames, but the bitrate listed is twice what I usually have it at. Let's try this. I'm going to cut the stream and then bring it back.